Welcome to my 3-minute lecture. This session will provide an overview of Chapter 7. We've already seen how an argument may be weakened by poor structure, logical inconsistency, and hidden assumptions. Here, we examine other fallacies, oversights, and assumptions. Note the examples. These represent common errors in reasoning. Why do these flaws occur? Authors may not recognize their own arguments have flaws. However, they may intend to manipulate their audience by misleading them and deliberately distorting reasoning or intentionally misusing language to create particular responses. It may be used to exaggerate a point to influence the audience or to deflect from a weak argument overall. It's flawed reasoning to assume that because two things are found together or occur at the same time, there must be a link between them, such as jumping to the conclusion that there's a cause and effect. Sunny weather may increase the likelihood of sunburns and also increase the consumption of ice cream, but there's no causal relationship between ice cream and sunburn. The same is true of ice cream and shark attacks. A necessary condition is just as it sounds. It's an essential requirement. If it's not present, there's a gap in the argument and the outcome could be different. If the outcome could be different, then the argument isn't proved. It's important to bear in mind that there may be many necessary conditions or requirements for proving a case. If this, then that. Sufficient conditions form the totality of all of those conditions that must be met in order to secure a particular argument. If sufficient conditions are met, then a particular set of consequences must follow. Here's another example to illustrate. If it's drizzling or sprinkling, it's not pouring, but it is raining. However, if it's pouring, it requires that it is raining. Analogies compare two completely different things to each other. It takes critical evaluation to determine if a comparison is valid for its context. If the elements being compared do not share enough similarities or are not relevant to the issue at hand, the analogy is too weak to be used justifiably. Look at the examples. These leaps in reason are common errors when developing an argument, erroneously thinking it's countering the opposing position. Language can be used to construct a powerful argument or produce flaws in the line of reasoning that confuse the audience whether the argument is valid or divert them from the line of reasoning. Fallacies are common errors in reasoning that undermine the logic of your argument. Fallacies can be either illegitimate arguments or irrelevant points and are often identified because they lack evidence that support their claim. To spot logical fallacies, look for bad proof or a disconnect between the proof and the conclusion. Links to the example sites are in the video comments. Tautological arguments repeat the same points in different words without advancing the argument, repeating the concept. This chart shows examples of redundancy in language. Repeating yourself in your argument without adding new information or evidence is tautological. Circular reasoning is an argument defect where the argument fails to persuade because there's no reason to accept the premises unless you already believe the conclusion, or that the premises provide no independent ground or evidence for the conclusion. This is closely related to tautology. Fallacies and faulty reasoning diminish the power of an argument. Make sure to review this week's lecture for resources that dive deeper into these topics. Thanks for watching.